Ash from Elevate My Faith, and today I just wanted to do like a little like fun start of summer vlog. I was just in the mood to like do a little day in my life, so we'll just see how it goes. So I wanted to show you guys the work in progress in the baby room. Lots going on. So we have a giant king bed in here that we have to cut up and just get out of here. Lots of things being moved around right now. Trying to get the closets a bit organized because we're gonna take those two down, and then my dad's gonna help build like an actual like big closet right there on this wall because we don't have like a lot of closet space. Like that's just a really tiny closet there. So yeah, there's the baby seat we got already from a family member. So yeah, lots just going on in here. Once we get this bed out of here, that'll help a lot. Yeah, this was just our like guest room, and our parents gave us this king bed to use in there because they got a new one, but now we clearly just won't need it. Unfortunately, we just have to rip it up because they don't take like donated mattresses, you know, for places because they have to worry about bed bugs and stuff. So, but it definitely got its use. It's an old mattress. I'll have to get my keyboard out here too, I think. Find a spot for that. But yeah, so just lots going on. And just wanted to show you guys some of the small progress. We'll get more done today. My dad comes over to help out my husband. And I'll keep you guys updated on this room. So for breakfast today, I'm just doing apple cinnamon rice cake with peanut butter and chocolate chips. I originally tried to put like fruit on top or something a little healthier, but I don't really have any fruit right now. And I've been craving chocolate a little bit, so I figured I'd get my fill in while being somewhat healthier than like a candy bar. So yeah. Actually been 2 days later because I totally forgot I was in the middle of doing a daily vlog and finishing it up. So now I'm just gonna show you guys the after for the baby room and all the work that's been put into it because we got the king bed out of here, and yeah, lots more space, got some more things out of the room. So yeah, just excited to keep working on this room. And I want to show you guys what I was working on when I was at the coffee shop the other day. So I was doing Psalm 14 and 15. I usually try to do like a psalm a day, but I felt like I could do two in one day because they were smaller, and sometimes I've been missing my days here and there. So Psalm 14 is just all about the fool says there is no God, and I journaled a little bit on that. I try to write down about every psalm. So for that one, I put, this psalm just shows that people definitely don't act any different from then to now. There's still many foolish people saying there isn't a God. I think deep down they know, but don't want to be held accountable and just be free, quote unquote, to do whatever they want. Meanwhile, true freedom is living in Christ and not the world. And then I was just going over Psalm 15, which is really great because it's just all about like who shall dwell on God's holy hill. So like who is walking in Christ and the traits of like, you know, a person walking in Christ, like who walks blamelessly, does what is right, speaks truth in his heart. So that was really good to reflect over. And I liked what my Bible had to say about this Psalm, relative righteousness. Books such as Psalms and Proverbs refer frequently to righteousness in order to contrast between the righteous and the wicked, while much of the New Testament speaks of righteousness in a different sense, perfection. This distinction is important to note as the former expresses relative righteousness, which compares humans to humans, whereas the latter expresses absolute righteousness, which compares humans to God. When David asked who shall dwell on your holy hill, he was describing what the people of God should look like. Relative righteousness looks like doing good, telling the truth, keeping oaths, ethical lending, and more. Of course, the expression of relative righteousness in comparison with those who are not God's people is an outworking of the imputed absolute righteousness of Christ. Romans 10:4 says, Christ is the end of the law for righteousness to everyone who believes. For those who are in Christ, then, God's righteousness has been freely given to them through faith and can now be joyfully manifested by living a righteous life that looks like David's description in Psalm 15 is empowered by God himself. So, yeah, sorry, my vlog ended like 2 days later because my pregnancy brain made me forget I was vlogging, but I just wanted to tie up some loose ends with showing like the before and after, moving some things around the baby room and just what I was going over for Bible studying and stuff like that. So, yeah, I hope you guys just enjoyed this little like day in my life vlog, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye! Amazing grace, how sweet.